I will be handed over to the most cruel fate you could ever imagine. And he talked about that throughout his ministry. And if the context is the Last Supper, and Jesus is looking at his friends, his disciples, these very awkward people, some of them very undesirable people, that he asked him to to follow him. And he says, do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, that I told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and I prepare a place for you, I will come back and I will take you to myself, so that where I am going, you may know the way. Remember what Thomas said, Master, we don't know where you go. He's very practical, Thomas. He's not so much doubting, practical. Master, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way? I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one goes to the Father except through me. Jesus was given us a context. He knows how to read us, but more importantly, he's telling us that in the Father's house, there are many dwelling places, and it's a place for each one of us. How does that change your experience of God? You're on a journey. Jesus has shown you the way. He's taught you the truth in love. He's told you how to restore broken relationships. He's shown us the example, how to make things right when things go wrong. But more importantly, he offers us an end and a new beginning. Beauty of Jesus. You know, there's a place in John's Gospel where the first time Jesus speaks is when John is there with his two disciples, right? And he's watching Jesus walk by and says, look, there's the Lamb of God. And the two disciples are looking at John thinking, what was thought we were doing right following you, so they leave him. And they go to Jesus. The first words spoken by Jesus in John's Gospel, you know what they are? What are you looking for? What are you looking for? So in order to really engage our faith, we have to ask that question, what am I looking for? In this experience of the church, what am I looking for? Am I looking for the way? Am I looking for the truth? Am I looking to share that life in that unbelievable experience of an empty tomb in which Jesus is risen? So one of the things that Jesus says when they respond, where do you live? He said, come and see. And I think a challenge for ourselves in the new evangelization is subjectively we need to go and see where Jesus lives and objectively put it out there so others may know of his presence. You know, so where is Christ to be found? There's challenges in our present culture. It's materialism, it's noise, it's in a relativism where people are challenged to live a truth, and sometimes it's easy to explain the truth away just out of necessity not to be bothered and challenged by the Word of God. You know, when I think of the young people today, they have so many challenges. You know, here I am talking about the subjectivity of faith, of knowing Christ. And they're in such a fast-paced world that some of us have become part of. A fast-paced world. And you know, you'll see them doing so many tasks at one given time. I ask you to think about your own domestic church, your own family. How many times have you seen sons or daughters or grandchildren or nephews and nieces sitting down in a group of their peers? somebody else. It's a terrible reality that we've come to, because what our technology has done, it's gifted us in so many ways, but in other ways, it's often a challenge because it's taken away the gift of the present moment. But people are not at ease with the people in front of them. That they're constantly going beyond that experience, they want to have another experience at the same time. You know, when you're traveling in a car, and I know I've said this over at St. John the Evangelist, I was with the Vicar General one day, and he's a nervous driver, by the way, and I always have to drive when we're going to Venice. So we're coming out of Fort Myers, we're on our way to Highway 75, and I stopped, and there's a beautiful-looking blonde girl in the car next to me, right? And I said, Ed, look at her. He said, Ludden, stop it.